Hi friends, good morning all of you and welcome back to our online class Maths 7th standard. Friends, today we are going to continue our the third chapter, that is the decimals. Okay, in previous classes already we have discussed about that, what are the like decimals and unlike decimals, but today we are going to discuss about that comparison of the decimals. Okay friends, comparison means you have to find out which decimal is greater or which is smaller. Okay, so before that, how we should compare? So let us see that. So students, whenever you are going to compare the two decimals, first of all you have to identify the places and what are the numbers. Okay, and how you should compare, there will be one steps you have to follow. First of all, I already informed in the previous video, the decimal numbers having the two parts. One is whole number parts, another one is decimal parts or integral parts or decimal parts. Okay friends, so already I have told, suppose 32.358, suppose, so then this is two parts. One is, this is called as decimal parts and this is called as integral part or whole number parts. Whole number parts, or also we can say also integral parts. Okay, so this is two parts, means what you have to do whenever you will compare, first step you have to check both decimals integral parts. That means suppose here given 31.198, suppose two numbers we are comparing. So first of all, this number integral part is 32, this number integral part is 31. First of all, this integral part you should compare. Okay, so now we observe that what, 32 is greater than 31. First integral part you compare, then if you check, you can find out if one is greater, one is small, then which number is greater now? 32. So this number is greater than this number, whole number. Okay, this whole part, this is greater whenever we are comparing. But if suppose if both are number same, suppose you will see, I am writing once again, 32.758, again one more I am writing here, 32.843. So this is two decimals, so we are comparing which is greater. So what you have to do, students, first of all we have to check that integral part, then decimal part we have to check. The integral part is the first, you observe that these two number you have to compare. So this is 32, this is also 32, so same integral part, same. So go for right side, decimal part you go. Decimal part which number you have to check first, check 10th place. What is that students? This is the 10th. First you check the 10th place. After the decimal, first place you should check, that is called as the 10th place you have to check. Here what is that? 7. Here what is that? 8. So you will compare these two numbers, then 8 is greater. Hence this number is greater than this number. Okay, are you clear? Same like if suppose this 10th place are same, suppose like this is there, then what you have to do? Now check first integral part, same thing. Now 10th place also same, both are same, 7 7. Now go for 100th place. This 100th place you check, 5 is greater than this. Hence, this number is greater than this number. Gradually, like that, you have to check and go first 10th place. Next, sorry, first integral part, whole number part, then after 10th place, next 100th place, next 1000th place, like that, so on. Okay? But if you are correct, okay, now you found that which one is greater or which one is smaller, then you directly stop there and select that which number is greater. Are you clear? Okay, friends, let us start now. Some examples I have written here. You should start that which is greater, which is smaller. Comparison of decimals, friends. First of all, we have to find out which is greater. First question, see, students, read the first question. 14.998 or 15.001. What did I say? First, I tell to you. First, you have to check the integral part of the decimal. Integral part which one now here? 14. Yes. This integral part is 15. So this two number if you will compare, what will get? Will get 15 is greater than 14. Yes, 15 is greater than 14. Hence, what will get? If 15 is greater than 15, whose number? This number. So this number is greater than this number. Hence, 15.01 is greater than 14.998. Are you clear, friends? So observe that, friends. First integral part you have to check. Integral part, if it is greater or smaller, if you have found, then you go for that other 10th place or 100th place or 1000th place. But now you have selected the integral part is greater now here, then no need to go for the decimal places. Okay, so now it's selected. Come to the second B, 3.02 or 3.20. Okay, friends. Now you check integral part 3, here also 3. So both are same. So now we have to go for the decimal place. So decimal place, which number you have to check faster? 10th place. First you have to check the 10th place. Here what is the switch 10th place? 0. What is the 10th place here? 2. So 2 is greater than 0. Now you check the here 0, here 2. So 2 is greater. This number is greater. So 2 is greater than, hence this number, whole number, total number is greater. 3.20 is greater than 3.0. Okay? Same like you should do this. First of all, check that integral part, here 2, here 2, same. Now go for the 10th place, 6, here 6, same. 100th place, 8, here 8, same. If same, then we are going to next place. So now next time we are going to 1000th place. Here C 4, here C 1, then this is greater. Okay, so we can write 4 is greater than 1, hence 2.684 is greater than 2.681. Are you clear, students? Did you understand about this? Okay, I hope you have understood. So, first of all, only one thing you have to remember, friends. You compare them to the two decimal numbers, integral part number you check first. If both decimal numbers, integral part are both are same, then you go to the 10th place of both decimals. Then compare to the 10th place. If both are same, then you go for the next 100th place. Then you choose which one is greater or smaller. If you found that smaller or greater, then according to that, the number is greater, which is smaller, and you can select. If 100th place also, 100th place also same, then what you have to do? You have to go for 1000th place, like that, so on. Okay? So, I hope you have understood this all the comparison of the decimals. Students, now we are going to express about that conversion. That means smaller number to big number or big number to smaller number, how to convert in decimals using decimals, we have to understand. Students, you know 1 kilogram, how much grams? 1000 grams. Yes or no? 1 kilogram is 1000 grams. So whenever you express in grams, kilograms, so remember, students, it is given to you grams. It is given to you grams. Okay, and converting into kilograms. So the two things you are remembering now. Grams converting into kilograms. So which one is big quantity? The kilogram is big. Okay, big unit is the kilogram. So 1 kilogram, how much gram? 1000 grams. So when grams converting to the kilogram, then you divide 1000. Remember, friends, 1 kilogram is equal to how much gram, friends? 1000 grams. So whenever grams converting to kilogram, then that number with 1000 divided. Only one thing only remember, gram to converting kilogram, that time you should divide with the 1000s. Okay, now check. 3470 grams is equal to what you can do? 3470 by 1000 kilogram. And remember, friends, whenever gram is converting kilogram, that time you have to divide 1000. Remember only one thing, gram to converting kilogram, that time we are dividing 1000, because 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams. You will make it decimal, that you check it, what will come? See, friends, Here three zeros are there. So from right side 1, 2, 3. Per you 3.470 kilogram. Are you clear? So 3.470 kilograms. Okay. Same experiment. This one 12 kg 8 grams. Already 12 kg दे दिया. Already given you. So what can I do? 12 kg plus 8 grams. 8 grams means 8 by 1000. I told when gram you are converting to kilogram by 1000. 12 kg plus 8 by 1000 means here 3 zeros are there. So here 1 digit is there. Again 2 digits needed. So we can put 008 kilogram. So if you add what will get? 12.008 kilogram. If you add this 12.008 kilogram. Are you clear, friends? So whenever gram converting to kilogram, we have to do like this way by thousands. Similar friends, 18 paise. What do you mean? 18 paise. 1 rupee, how much? You are giving that express in rupees. So 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. So what I am going to do, friends? Whenever paise is converting to rupee, at that time divided by 100. So what I am going to do? Now 18 by 100 rupees. Okay? Is equal to, if decimal there, if you do that decimal is given there, two digits up before that you have to give 0.180 rupees. Okay? Similarly, 325 paise is equal to 325 by 100 is equal to double zero is there. So, 0.2 here, two digits after, before you have to keep, so 3.2 rupees. Okay? So, same like here, friends, 88 rupees. So, we can write 88 rupees plus you can keep because already rupees already over. This one we have to convert. So, 88 by 100 rupees is equal to 88 plus this equal to this one will come here because two digits are there, two digits after you have before that you have to give. So, we can directly can write 88.88 rupees. Okay. So, students, here given same like it express 7 centimeter in meter and kilometer. Students, observe here 7 centimeter in meter and kilometer. So, first of all, this one is equal to how much? 1 meter is equal to, I am doing here, this is a solution. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. Okay. So first of all, we have to convert 7 centimeter in meter. 7 centimeter in meter is equal to, what will do? 7 cm is equal to meter converting. Whenever 1 meter to 2 centimeter we are converting, so by 100. So 7 by 100 meter is equal to how much will come, friends? Here 1 digit is there. Decimal to 0.07 meter. Now meter to kilometer. So 0.07 meter is equal to 1 meter, that means 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So meter converting kilometer means by 1000. 0.07 by 1000 kilometer is equal to 3 zeros are there, friends. So decimal it will come to 3 places again. Already 0.7 is there kilometer. Okay, same like students, you have to do this one. You try to change for your homework. You do this one. Express 45 millimeter in centimeter, 45 millimeter centimeter converting after centimeter to meter, meter to kilometer. You should try to do. If you confusion, next tomorrow, next video, I will explain this. Okay, friends. Thank you all.